Our topic today is asexual reproduction again, and we'll be talking about few other methods of asexual reproduction. Another important method by which the reproduction is brought about is budding. Now, there are various organisms which undergo the process of budding or the formation of the bud. In this method, the mature organism starts developing an outgrowth, and this outgrowth is known as bud. And the individual on maturation who is carrying the bud will be the parent body. Now, the bud will grow at the expense of the parent body. That means it will derive its nutrition from the parent, and it will continue to develop due to continuous or repeated cell divisions which are taking place over there. And after a certain period of growth, the individual, that is the bud, will acquire all the necessary parts, all the necessary structure which is required to exist as an independent individual. After it has attained the desirable size or desirable properties, it will detach from the parental body and will exist as an individual which is new, and the parent will also exist. So in the case of Hydra, if you see, these are the tentacles, and this is a mature Hydra which has started developing the bud. The bud is growing in size, and it develops over there in the third step with the tentacles, and the body is sufficiently developed. In the next phase, that is the fourth step, the parent body will release the bud, that is the newly formed individual, and as a result, the parent and the new individual will be surviving. Budding has its own advantages because it does not cause much of expense of energy. Another type of asexual reproduction we'll be talking is vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation is seen in plants only, and it is the method of reproduction in which only the root, stem and the leaves take part in reproduction. That means these parts develop new plants. That is why we call it as vegetative propagation. So here the roots, the stem and the leaves are taking part in the formation of new plant. This method or vegetative propagation is being highly used. For example, you must have seen money plant. Money plant, if we pluck the stem of the money plant between the node and internode, there is, you know it, that these are the nodes, you see the thick part, and in between is the elongated portion, that is the internode. If we break the money plant from here and put it in water or soil, the part will develop as a new plant. So this is a method of vegetative propagation. There are many such plant varieties which we see around us, which either develop by root or by stem or by the leaves. Again, another example is bryophyllum leaf. Bryophyllum leaf has certain areas which are known as notches on the border of the leaf. So if this is the border, there are the certain notches, and it is at these notches the new bud will start developing. After the sufficient growth, this bud will detach, fall on the soil, and will give rise to new plant. So there are many cases of vegetative propagation. Sugarcane is another example. Sugarcane, banana, all these are plants which are using vegetative propagation for the formation of new individuals. Now, the vegetative propagation has definite advantages. The plants which are developed from this method bear flowers and fruits early. That means they grow very rapidly and they develop flowers and the fruits much earlier as compared to the plants which develop by seeds. Then also they help, this method enables the seedless plants to continue with their species. There are many seedless varieties such as banana, orange, rose. Those plants can propagate themselves with the help of this method. Another advantage is they are genetically similar. Since they are genetically similar, the good properties can be retained in a plant. So many kinds of variations are not there, and as a result, the plant maintains the properties. This technique is used extensively in agriculture, especially in horticulture and agriculture. This is being used extensively to grow sugarcane, and layering and crafting has enabled the various large amount of growth of grape, and all those plants are utilized, which are used as a commercial product, are used in using this vegetative propagation method. And this method also has an advantage that large number of individuals can be produced in a very short span of time. So over here, if we talk about money plant or if we talk about rose, if we use the grafting method, that is cutting and putting another graft, then we can develop 3 or 4 plants together, or maybe more. Or in the case of money plant, if we break the stem of the plant into 4 or 5 types, we have 4 or 5 plants together in a quick, in a very short period of time. So vegetative propagation has definitely been found to be very, very useful in growing various kinds. Potato is a very good example. You see the eyes of the potato. Potato, you must have seen, it has eyes. And nowadays, in the rainy weather, you can see the plants or small buds coming out from it. If you cut that portion and grow it, it will develop or as a new plant. So these are the various advantages of vegetative propagation.